These Kung Fu Panda movies have to have one of the stupidest titles I've ever heard for a movie. I mean, seriously, Kung Fu Panda, just... that sounds like an old 90s Nicktoon show or something like that. So it's already been 5 years, half a decade, since Kung Fu Panda 2 was in theaters. And as we saw at the end of Kung Fu Panda 2, Po's dad is actually alive and he's living in this panda village. So his dad comes and finds him, takes him back to the panda village so he can learn how to be a panda. All the while, there's a new villain in town named Kai, who's a spirit who was in the spirit realm. Now he's back and he's harnessing the chi of all these kung fu masters to turn them into like an army for him. And I gotta say, these Kung Fu Panda movies are really solid, and this one is also really good. What I like about them is that it's a continuous story. Po is learning something new in each movie. That was one of the things that I loved about the second one. I think the second one is still my favorite, because in 3, they do retread a few small notions that they learned in the first movie, but on the whole, he's advancing in his kung fu mastery. That's awesome. And the voice cast for these movies is always solid, like Jack Black, Angelina Jolie, Dustin Hoffman. He wasn't in the movie a lot. Just like in 2, he wasn't in a lot, but I loved the character of Shifu. In the first movie, he was a little bit crankier, and he was dealing with the regret about Tai Lung and all of that, and he was more like Mick from Rocky. But in 2 and 3, he is like Yoda. I thought he was really cool. And jumping into the new characters, you have Bryan Cranston playing Po's dad, who's always awesome. He's Bryan Cranston. He's the Heisenberg. No one talks smack about the Heisenberg. And playing the villain, you have J.K. Simmons. Another thing that I really like about these Kung Fu Panda movies is that they always have really good villains. And they always pick, like, the perfect villainous voices to portray these characters. Like in the first one, you had Ian McShane. Second one, Gary Oldman. This one, you have J.K. Simmons. And J.K. Simmons has big shoes to fill because Ian McShane and Gary Oldman were both so great in 1 and 2. And I'm sure DreamWorks was just like, okay, who do we get to replace Gary Oldman? Then they saw Whiplash and they were just like, oh, yeah, I think he'd be a good choice actually. But I'm calling it. If they make a Kung Fu Panda 4, Po is going up against either Idris Elba or Jeremy Irons. It just has to happen. The animation's really fluid and solid. The kung fu fights look amazing. If I have issues with this movie, it's that some of the jokes don't always land. Like, there's a lot of really funny jokes in this movie, but there are even some where the kids in the theater weren't even laughing. And like I said earlier about it slightly retreading the first movie, this one does that in the joke department as well. Like, remember in the first movie when he first sees the five and he's all, oh, you're so much bigger than all my action figures. Except for you, Mantis. You're about the same. And then a custom Mantis and you see his little antenna like flicker. There's a joke that is beat for beat that exact same scene. And there was a point for me, I'd say it was about half hour into this movie, where it just clicked and I was like, all right, I know exactly how this entire movie is going to play out now. And I'm not going to spoil it here, but the movie does end up kind of just playing a by-the-numbers story near the end of it. But it's not always about the destination, sometimes it's about the journey, and the journey getting to that ending was still a lot of fun. You know, apart from the Toy Story sequels, Pixar hasn't really been known for doing sequels too well, mainly with Cars 2, and then Monsters University was like, it was good, but it wasn't Monsters, Inc. level. DreamWorks, on the other hand, does really good sequels. I feel like they learned their lesson after Shrek 3 and just saw how the franchise completely dropped after that movie. And they were just like, all right, we can't phone in any of these sequels. So, like, we got Madagascar 3, we got How to Train Your Dragon 2, and both Kung Fu Panda sequels I really enjoy. So if you're a fan of the first two Kung Fu Panda movies, you're probably gonna enjoy this one. If I had to place this one in with the others, I'd say it's, like, on par with the first one, but not as good as the second. It's a fun family movie. If you guys go see it this weekend, you're gonna have a blast. And we're officially at the end of January now, and it actually wasn't that bad. But your favorite kung fu movie of all time, whatever it is, comment down below, let me know. Mine, dude, is The Matrix. That thing is awesome. But if you like this video, click subscribe to see the other videos that I'm putting out, and I'll catch you guys next time. Everybody was kung fu fighting.